Before we delve into the project that I made, I just want to share the story on how I got started in playing Mobile Legends. Actually, this is my first MOBA type of game. Well, basically the story is, I just got invited by some of my friends to play with them. Ganun naman nato talaga, yayain ka maglaro. I am a fan of using the quick chat, but sometimes, I find the things you can say from there is not enough. They did increase the number of things you could say on the quick chat relative from before. But in this video, let's call them text macros. Is there any way to add more? Also, what if I wanted my own? That's when I tried to figure out how to solve this. So I thought to automate the chat. Let's call this chat macros. Initially, I tried software-based macros, but that did not go well. It could also be detected that we are running a third-party program, and that might be classified as something else. So what I did next is to test USB devices compatibility. The first USB device I tried was a gamepad. No, it does work, but not really for what I intended it to. Second, I tried a mouse. Oh look, I can move the mouse, but I cannot click on things. Lastly, I tried the keyboard. Oh, you can control your character or something. I can even type. Aha, I can type. I just have to automate the typing. Maybe I can find a way to have a macro in a keyboard to work. But a keyboard is bulky anyway. So I made a proof of concept. It has a microcontroller that acts as HID, a human interface device. In this case, a keyboard. It has 4 buttons for the chat macros, and the LEDs are just for debugging and status stuff. The chat macros can be set. Actually, it is not really designed to be in a case, but I designed a 3D printed one. I recently got this 3D printer. Anyway, to set the chat macros, I made a Python program to go along with it for the PC, which my girlfriend helped me finish. And it made the setting of chat macros dynamic. Because initially, the chat macros are hard-coded on the program which is running on the microcontroller. And I had to reprogram the microcontroller itself every time I had to change the chat macros. And that was tedious. The settings program is straightforward. You have 2 buttons which are read and write. This drop-down button here is for you to select the hardware. And you have 4 text boxes here where you will type what you want to say. Also, red data will appear here. Just like that. These on the sides are character counters as the Mobile Legends chat only has a 40 character limit. But having a PC all the time just to change and read settings of the hardware is impractical. So I wrote an Android app just for it. The hardware's for phone use anyway. The Android app is practically the same as the one on the PC. If you are wondering if I wrote this with Flutter, yes, I used Flutter. You need an OTG adapter to plug this in. My phone here uses a USB Type-C. When you plug this in, the cable connected to your phone might get in the way of your gameplay. It would be nice if you have another USB port somewhere around here, here, or here. I think there are phones that are like that. But oh well. Actually, my codename to this project is Macro Legends. Yes, a pun. I was like, ML. Aha, ML. And that was it. Okay, let's see it in action. I know that going back and forth from the phone and pressing buttons on the device is tiresome. Maybe we could make it something that attaches here so that it is close, but then again, it's a proof of concept. Basically, this is just a keyboard with predefined things to type. As the uncle of Spider-Man said, with great power comes great current squared times resistance. I mean, comes great responsibility. So to prevent spam in Mobile Legends is to detect the characters per second type and also have a cooldown for the typing. Also detect if the same message is sent repeatedly. There was no muting of players before, but now they implemented one. So I guess they just have to detect spam, not just swear words. See, there's a cooldown for those. But not for the chat. The principle could be retrofitted to other games, not just Mobile Legends. Look, it can even work with Wild Rift out of the box. So, what games would you use this for if you have one? So yeah, that's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Till next time.